this video, I'm going to introduce the new card of the climate fresque, Growing Inequality. So, why did we create this new card? The latest IPCC report presents the increase in inequality as a consequence of climate change. It also mentions mitigation and adaptation measures. The IPCC stresses that without a reduction in global inequality, the climate objectives cannot be achieved. This card clearly highlights the issues of social justice and climate justice. There are many links between this card and the other cards. The increase in inequality can be linked to all extreme climate phenomena because, as we have already seen, these events hit the most vulnerable countries and populations the hardest. And that accentuates inequality. It also amplifies the risk of armed conflicts, famines, the impacts on human health, and the risks of population displacement. This card is part of set 5. You can distribute it to the participants, along with the other cards. If you're used to getting people to guess the last 4 cards, you can also get them to guess this one. It may not come out as easily, but that's what makes it interesting. As with the human health, famines, armed conflicts, population displacement, you can choose to use this card as a discussion tool during the last phase of the workshop. You can point to it when talking about orders of magnitude. For example, if you present the graph on the distribution of emissions and living standards, or the graph on cumulative greenhouse gases emissions. You can also use it again when discussing actions. It differs from the other cards, as it opens up deeper, more ethical, even philosophical discussions. And because this card is new, its use has yet to be invented. So we're trusting you to try out different things. Please share your experience and have the other members of the community challenge it. Let's rely on collective intelligence, as we've always done. Now, let's go into a little more detail about the card. It states that climate change reinforces social and economical inequality between individuals, between countries, and between generations. Indeed, as the IPCC report states, vulnerable communities who have historically contributed the least to current climate change are disproportionately affected. Inequality between countries are also reinforced. If the main historical polluters do not participate in helping the countries that are most affected, this will intensify inequality. The costs of mitigation and adaptation must be shared fairly. This is climate justice. It is very important to introduce this notion at this point of the workshop. Climate justice should become an obvious concept for everyone and no longer only be associated to climate activism. Also, past and present generations who have benefited from industrial development and a mild climate must take the measure of the impact and reduce it now. They must do so for the sake of present and future generations, so that they too can look forward to a viable future. Failure to act would mean increasing inequality between generations, between those who had it all and those who will have to survive the consequences. In a world with a limited carbon budget, the living standards of some people today are mechanically at the expense of the basic needs of others elsewhere or later. And when we say later, that includes our children. The card then goes on to mention that climate policies need to be made fair and equitable to avoid inequality getting worse. Indeed, adaptation and mitigation measures are not as easy to implement for everyone. For example, thermal renovation of buildings or vehicle renewal may not be feasible for the poorest people, widening the gap even further. It is therefore necessary to reduce inequality to be able to implement these measures, either by having a highly redistributive tax system or by putting in place subsidies that are genuinely targeted at the most disadvantaged. If this sentence has not already been discussed during the reflection phase, it is worth highlighting it during the final phase about actions. You could, for example, mention the potential impacts of these actions on reducing inequality, both locally and globally. Why remove the thermo-aligned circulation card? For several years now, the Fresk has been advertised as being based on a set of 42 cards. And changing that would mean updating a lot of documents. So if we add one card, we have to remove another. Moreover, a lot of Freskers have pointed out that they're not comfortable with this card and that they systematically put it aside. So we decided to remove the thermo-aligned circulation card and add the inequality card instead. However, thermo-aligned circulation will still be present in the expert fresk, which you are invited to do with other freskers from the yellow belt upwards.